Today I'm going to show you a 2014 American war film called Fury. The movie begins with a narration of the war of Nazi soldiers against the Allied countries. A Nazi soldier is riding a white horse and inspecting the remains of battle when he is jumped and killed with Sergeant Don Collier, also known in war as War Daddy. War Daddy lets the horse go and goes back inside the tank named Fury. Inside are his troops, namely Boyd Bible Swan, Trini Gordo Garcia, and Grady Kunas Travis. Kunas is fixing them when he blames War Daddy for what happened to them. They're all messed up and devastated by the death of one of their comrades when they're attacked. The right timing for Kunas to finish fixing Fury, they head out of the battlefield. Back in the camp of the Allies, War Daddy is greeted by Sergeant Binkowski. After talking for a while, War Daddy is approached by a soldier and asks where the rest of the platoon are, but War Daddy and his men are the only ones left. Meanwhile, Bible, Gordo, and Kunas talk about Red, their fallen comrade. War Daddy, then, arrives and gives an order to them. Alone, War Daddy is seen devastated by Red's death too. After a while, he is approached by Private Norman Ellison. Norman introduces himself as War Daddy's new assistant driver and bow gunner. Looking at Norman, War Daddy cannot believe what he is hearing. Norman Ellison just got in the army for 8 weeks. War Daddy tells him to go to the rest of the troop, follows orders, and not get too close to anyone. Norman finds the others fixing Fury. Gordo takes his bag and looks for a cigarette, but only finds a book. The three ask him about his job in the army and intimidate him. Then, Kunas orders him to clean the insides of Fury. Norman, for the first time, sees the inside of a tank. He starts cleaning the blood off when he spots a torn off face. He immediately gets out of the tank and puke. Meanwhile, War Daddy is talking to other soldiers about their situation when an SS soldier prisoner is brought into the camp. War Daddy and the others attack the prisoner, but he is stopped by his comrades. He, then, tells Norman that he should kill every German soldier he sees. It turns out that Norman hasn't killed anyone yet. War Daddy gives him a gun, and Kunas teaches him about it. War Daddy proceeds to talk to other soldiers about their next move. War Daddy will be the platoon sergeant for their mission. After the discussion of the plan, they mount up and head out. On their way, they drive past people evacuating. War Daddy warns them to stay alert for hidden enemies among the people. Then, Norman notices someone from the tree line, but hesitates to shoot it. Unfortunately, this causes a successful ambush by the enemy. A tank explodes, and Norman sees a soldier burning and shooting himself to death. War Daddy immediately chases the enemy and kills them. The enemies who ambush them are just kids. War Daddy gets back to Norman, and scolds him for hesitating to kill the enemy. Now, Norman carries the burden of someone dying because of his negligence. War Daddy takes the lead of the whole platoon, and proceeds with the mission. They reach their destination, and a soldier greets them. The soldier takes War Daddy to Captain Wagoner. He's frustrated to know that they didn't send the sufficient number of backup he asked, but he trusts War Daddy, so he's still somehow confident with him. They discuss the mission to rescue the captain's pinned down soldiers in the enemy's territory. Then, they gear up and proceed with the mission. The platoon reaches the pinned down soldiers and starts rescuing them. Tanks in front, soldiers at the back. Then, the enemy start firing at them and a shootout broke out. The enemies have strong machine guns and anti-tank weapons. Meanwhile, Norman is still not used in fighting. A soldier was about to shoot them, and he cannot shoot back because he's panicking while reloading the gun. Fortunately, Bible saves him. Gordo scolds Norman, then orders him to shoot the enemy lying on the ground. Norman doesn't want to, thinking they're already dead, but Gordo insists on double tapping them. Norman breaks down and doesn't want to fight anymore. War Daddy scolds him, and Gordo consoles him, saying it's all part of the war. After a while, they successfully defeated the Nazi soldiers. A soldier approaches a dying man and prays for him. War Daddy talks to Norman about his mistakes. It turns out that Norman is not trained for combat, he's just been pulled out and sent to Germany. Then, other soldiers caught a Nazi soldier wearing an American jacket and toys with him. War Daddy stops them, and orders Norman to kill the Nazis. When he refuses, War Daddy wrestles the revolver into Norman's hand, forcing him to pull the trigger. The Nazi dies with the revolver in his hand, traumatizing Norman. Bible picks him up, and they go back to the group. The three tell Norman that even though War Daddy is often hard, he's the main reason why their group is solid. On their way to the nearby town, they see dead bodies hanging. It's the Germans who refuses to fight in the war. They arrive at the town, and search it for hiding German soldiers. They spot an old man, and ask him where the soldiers are, but he was shot as soon as he pointed where they are. Then, a shootout breaks out. In the end, War Daddy and his platoon successfully capture the town when the Burgermeister surrenders. A bunch of kids and women, whose force to fight the war was rescued, and they kill their leader. Afterward, the soldiers celebrate their victory. Gordo and Kunas is flirting with a German woman, taking her inside Fury, and consecutively having meat injection game with her. Meanwhile, War Daddy approaches Norman and commends him for killing the enemies. Norman, on the other hand, responds with sarcasm. War Daddy, then, takes him to an office full of dead people. Talking about war ideals, War Daddy wants to make Norman realize something. When they step outside, War Daddy spots a woman peeking from the window. He and Norman immediately check the woman's apartment. In there, they find Irma and her younger cousin, Emma, hiding. War Daddy decides to settle there for a while, paying Irma 2 packs of cigarettes for a meal and hot water so he can shave. While the women are preparing the food, they're all surprised, including War Daddy, to hear Norman plays the piano. Emma walks to him and sings while he's playing. Then, War Daddy urges Norman to make his way to Emma, and the two go into the bedroom. Irma was about to stop them, but War Daddy calmly stops her, saying that she should let them enjoy it while they're young. Inside, Emma and Norman share an intimate time. After a while, they're about to eat when Bible, Gordo, and Kunas barge in. They say that a woman is waiting for Norman in the tank, but as soon as they see Emma, they realize what just happened. Then, they, especially Kunas, start bullying Norman and harassing Emma. But War Daddy stops them. All of them share a meal together when Gordo shares a story. Something is up, and tension is building up among the soldiers. War Daddy warns them not to spoil his mealtime, but Gordo continues the story about how to kill a horse. To kill a horse, you need to befriend it and gain its trust, and then you kill it. War Daddy warns him to shut up, but Bible and Kunas back him up. Afterward, War Daddy sarcastically thanks them for the talk, and slams the table, and spits on Kunas. Gordo apologizes when a soldier arrives, and calls for them. They're ordered to capture and hold onto a crossroad, but this mission is dangerous because they don't know what will they be facing. While preparing to leave, a German shell hits the town, exactly the house of Irma and Emma. Norman rushes to her and Kunas followed him. He finds Emma dead, further traumatizing him, but this fuels his anger for the Nazis. Kunas pushes him back to the tank, but he refuses. Then, Kunas lets him hit him to let out his frustrations, and pushes him back to the tank afterward. The platoon heads out, Norman is still devastated because of Emma's death. War Daddy talks to him, saying that death is all part of being in the war. On their way to the crossroad, they are ambushed. Enemy soldiers riding a Tiger tank attack them. The platoon is having a hard time finishing the enemy. Unfortunately, the enemy is able to take out Sergeant Davis, Sergeant Binkowski, and their men. Sergeant Davis was directly shot by the tank's cannon in the head, and Sergeant Binkowski burned to death. Fury, commanded by War Daddy, is now having a standoff with the Tiger tank. With War Daddy strategizing their attacks, they're able to destroy the Tiger tank and kill the enemy soldier. Just like at the beginning of the movie, War Daddy and his troop are the only ones left. War Daddy tries to notify his superiors of what happened but is unable to do so because the radio was damaged. Stressed and devastated, War Daddy, Bible, Gordo, Kunas, and Norman just laugh off their situation and proceed to carry on the mission. Fury reaches the crossroad but it got immobilized after stepping on a landmine. The tank tread gets cut off, and it will take a while to get fixed. War Daddy orders Kunas and Norman to check the nearby building. Inside the building, Kunas apologizes to Norman. After finding nothing but a dead German soldier, they immediately head back to the troop. Then, War Daddy orders Norman to guard them from the high ground. While eating, Norman hears something. Looking back, he's terrified to see a battalion of German soldiers marching their way. He rushes off to notify War Daddy and the others about the battalion coming. When War Daddy hears the chanting of the marching enemies, he recognizes them as the SS Battalion. Bible wants to leave, but War Daddy wants to stay. He insists that they must carry out their mission, but Kunas points out that the five of them don't stand a chance against a battalion of enemies. In the end, War Daddy permits them to leave if they want to. But he will stay and hold the crossroad because it is their mission, and as the platoon leader, he can't just abandon it. Norman decides to stay, and one by one, the others stay as well. They ask War Daddy about his plan, then, he orders them to get the dead German soldier and burn it. They also disguise Fury as a destroyed tank and hide inside. Taking into consideration the limited amount of ammo they have, they wait for the right timing to attack. Inside, while preparing their weapons, War Daddy finds alcohol, and they share their last drink. Knowing that this could be their last moment as a troop, Bible preaches about the verse he always thinks about. He is surprised when War Daddy recited the book and chapter, where his favorite verse came from. They also give Norman the war name Machine, because as Kunat says, he's a fighting, killing, and a sex machine. Afterward, Machine sees the enemy approaching their tank. He notifies the others and they all gear up. The enemy surround Fury, and when one soldier opens a hatch, Machine shoots him, and the fighting starts. In the battle of a battalion against five, this is the longest night they ever had. They throw grenades at the enemies, and blow up their tracks. They also blow up the nearby building where numbers of enemy soldiers hide when the shooting breaks out. The German soldiers start shooting back, but with War Daddy's command, the five are looking to be at advantage, killing many enemy soldiers. Unfortunately, they start running out of ammo. War Daddy plans to get out to get some ammo, and orders Gordo and Machine to cover him. They throw smoke grenades, and the two pop out their hatch and cover War Daddy as he gets the ammo. As soon as he finishes collecting ammo, he orders them to get back inside. He is about to get back inside as well, but enemies manage to climb up the tank. He fights them off, but gets shot in the process. Luckily, it's not a fatal wound. Bible patches up his wound, and they share another Bible verse together. On the other hand, the German soldiers bring out their Panzerfaust. They plan to swarm the group with continuous attacks. There is a brief silence echoing around. Both troops are being careful with each other, especially the troop of War Daddy, because they have a limited amount of ammo left. Then, the enemy start shooting them with Panzerfaust, and the five counterattacks. Unfortunately, one enemy manages to blow a hole in the side of Fury, and it goes through Kunas, killing him. Bible cries in agony, but War Daddy orders him to straighten up because they're still in the middle of the war. The four of them continue fighting, but there are too many German soldiers. They shoot and throw grenades at them at the same time. After a while, they finally ran out of ammo. All that's left to them are their hand weapons and Fury's .50 machine gun. On the other hand, the Nazi soldiers know they're running out of bullets, and plan to finish them off. Back to Fury, the four prepares to get out, and a shootout breaks out again. War Daddy positions himself in the machine gun, while the others are with their weapons. Later on, Bible runs out of bullets, and gets out to get one from a dead enemy. Meanwhile, Gordo is about to throw a grenade, but he's been shot. The grenade falls off inside the tank, and he uses his own body to contain the explosion, protecting War Daddy and Machine. Now, there are only three of them against the German soldiers. Outside, the Nazi whose Bible tries to steal his weapon from is still alive, and holds him down. He is about to get attacked by another enemy when Machine shows up and saves him. The two get back inside the tank when the enemies throw smoke grenades. Then, we see an enemy carrying a sniper, in camouflage, slowly crawling, and approaching near Fury. Back to War Daddy, he's fighting off the enemies when he calls for Bible to give him a grenade. But as soon as Bible pops out of the hatch, he is shot in the head by the sniper. The sniper fires again, and successfully hit War Daddy this time. Trying to secure the kill, he shoots him again, but War Daddy manages to get into the tank. Inside, War Daddy and Machine talk sincerely. Machine admits that he's scared, but so is War Daddy. Machine wants to surrender, but War Daddy tells him that they will torture him to death. Outside, the enemy soldiers swarm the tank and drop steel hand grenade. With one last glance with War Daddy, Machine escapes through the bottom hatch of the tank. He tries to cover himself with mud to hide, but a young German soldier spots him. Silently begging, the German soldier spares his life. The next morning, he's awakened by the sound of a white horse passing by. He gets back inside the tank and covers the dead body of War Daddy. Hearing noises from the outside, he gets War Daddy's revolver and prepares to fight. But he's relieved to see that the one who opens the hatch is an American soldier. Declaring that he's a hero, they bring him into an ambulance. The movie ends with a shot of Fury. Thank you for watching.